Welcome back. Let us recall what we are trying to do in the previous lecture. So, we are considering this autonomous system. F of x. So, let us call this equation 1. So, we are going to refer to this for the whole lecture. So, or in expanded form, we have this x j dot is equal to f j x 1 etcetera x n. And these are n equations for each j. And we are defining orbit through orbit, positive orbit, through a given point. X 0 in R n. The other terminology for orbit, those are synonyms, they are also called trajectories. This terminology also used. So, recall how did we define, for example, the orbit. So, similar remarks hold for positive orbit. So, we started with a solution. So, let x be a solution of 1 passing through x 0 at time t 0. What does this mean? That is x t 0 is x 0 and x satisfy the differential system x dot equal to f of x. Or in expanded form, each component of x satisfies these equations. And then the orbit was defined. So, then the orbit of x 0 is just set of all x in R n such that x equal to x t. So, the I am using all x, 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 but it should be clear from the context. So, what I am just taking is all this, I am varying t, for every t I just pick up that x of t coming from the solution. So, a natural question arises, natural doubt arises, what if I have another solution of 1 passing through x naught at a different time and then I use that solution to define the orbit. Do I get a different set? And obviously, I should not get, and let me state this as a lemma, and so it does not depend on the particular solution used for defining the orbit. So, let me state it as a lemma, lemma 1 prime. So, let x t, let me write that t y t be solutions of 1 satisfying x of t 0, sorry for that, t sub 0 x 0 and y of t 1 is equal to x 0. So, both the solutions are passing through the given point x 0. Maybe at different times. If they pass at pass through x naught at the same time, then by uniqueness they must be same. So, they might pass at different times for some t 0 t 1. Then the orbit through x naught, that is our purpose, defined. So, this is important using the solutions x and y. So, I will not get a different set. So, that is important. So, that remove the ambiguity. So, I can just use any solution passing through x naught. So, the time is not important. Okay. So, the only that solution has to pass through that given point, that is important. Okay. So, this will remove that ambiguity. So, so no special attention is given to that time t naught, only the solution. Okay. So, this proof is very quick. Okay. So, define z t is x of t plus t 0 minus t 1. Okay. So, recall that for the autonomous system, earlier we saw lemma 1, that if x t is a solution, then x of t plus c for any constant is also a solution. So, that defines this, that prove that this z t is also a solution. So, lemma 1 implies z is a solution of ok. So, moreover, now you compute z of t 1 also, z of t 1. So, you substitute t equal to t 1 in this expression. So, you get x of t 0, okay, and that is x 0, but x 0 is also equal to y of t 1. So, that is the hypothesis, you see, that is the hypothesis. So, now by uniqueness, so this is important. So, all the time we use this thing. So, by uniqueness, uniqueness of the initial value problem, uniqueness of IVP, z t is equal to y t for all t. So, the solutions z and y are the same because they have the same initial value at t equal to t 1. So, this condition implies that. So, uniqueness is an important thing. So, we all the time we use that. Okay, now look at z, look at y. So, z t is given by this expression. So, therefore, so this is an important thing for autonomous systems, and it is not true in general for non-autonomous systems. X of t plus t 0, sorry for that, t 0 minus t 1 for all t. So, though x and y are two different solutions, the only common thing they have, they pass through the same given point x 0 at different timings. They are related by this equation. So, they are not really different. Okay. So, similarly, you can use y, or you can just see here. So, similarly, you get x of t is equal to y of t. Now, you have to just change these arguments carefully. So, you have t plus t 1 minus t 0. Okay. So, therefore, so if you now go back to the definition of the orbit. So, what is orbit? So, I use that orbit through x naught. I just use that solution passing through x naught and collect all those points. So, therefore, if x is equal to x t or x tilde, let me say, for some t tilde, then x is also equal to, just look at the relation between x tilde and x of t tilde and y of t tilde, you get that y of t tilde plus t 1 minus t 0. And this entire thing I might just call it y t tilde. Okay. And similarly, if x is equal to y of some t tilde, I can get x is equal to x of t tilde. So, therefore, this completes, therefore, O of x naught is unambiguously defined. So, let me stress, what does that mean again? So, that means, I just take any solution passing through x naught, any solution of system 1 passing through x naught, and time is not important at all. Okay, I get the same set, and similar you can also now work out and just look at the definition of the positive orbit. So, you will also get the same. Similarly, so this positive orbit is unambiguously defined. Okay. So, what you all need is a solution passing through x naught. Okay. So, that simple clarification, and now immediately we see that. So, this is a note, remark. Okay. So, if x 1 belongs to an orbit passing through x 0, so that means there is a solution I am using here in the definition of this orbit. So, there is a solution passing through x naught at some time, that is not important, and the same solution will also be now passing through x 1. So, I can use that same solution to define orbit passing through x 1. Okay. Since it is the same solution, so I immediately get that x 0 is O of x 1. Okay. So, in lemma 1 prime, we have seen that it is only a solution passing through a given point that is important to define the orbit through that point. So, since the same solution that passes through x naught also passes through x 1 when x 1 is in the orbit of x naught. So, I can use the same solution and that implies immediately that orbit passing through x naught and orbit passing through x 1 are the same whenever x 1 lies on the orbit of x naught, and that also prove that x naught lies on the orbit of x naught passing through x 1. Okay. So, this implies, so a simpler proof, last time I stated that. So, lemma 2, let me again recall that. So, if we take two points in R n, x 0, x 1 in R n, and then consider the orbits passing through x naught and x 1. So, then is equal to x 1 or is empty. So, this is empty set. So, it says that any two orbits of the autonomous system 1, again, so remember that everything is in reference to the autonomous system 1, x dot equal to f of x. Okay. So, that is important. So, everything. So, if you have two orbits, either they are same or they are disjoint. So, there is nothing like, you know, they meet at one point and they are not equal. Okay. So, if they intersect at one point, then they must be equal. Okay. So, and this is now a simple proof. So, let me just, so if if x tilde belongs to O x 0. So, suppose their intersection is non empty. So, if there is intersection empty, then we do not have to prove anything. So, if suppose there is a common point between them, then you look at this note. Okay. So, then since x tilde belongs to the orbit passing through x naught. So, I have this is equal to x tilde, and x tilde also lies on the orbit passing through x 1, and that is equal to x 1. Okay. So, if they have a common point, then they must be equal. Okay. So, that is okay. So, now the question is, okay, now the previous lemma says about two orbits. What about the same orbit, can it intersect itself? Okay. So, this is the content of the next lemma. So, let me just write it. So, if suppose x t is a solution of 1. Satisfying. Okay. So, this is the condition I am. So, suppose that the orbit defined by the solution x intersects itself, satisfying x t 0 equal to x t 0 plus t for sum t0 in R and t positive. Okay. So, that t0 and t0 plus t are two distinct points, and suppose that intersects, then x t is equal. So, this is again a remarkable property. So, if it intersects at one point, then it has to do that thing for all time, not just for that one point. Okay. So, that is so again let me stress that one is an autonomous system, and these properties heavily use that fact, and so in general these properties of lemma 1, 2, etcetera are not satisfied by non-autonomous systems. So, this you have to bear it in mind. Okay. Again proof is very simple. Okay, the more than proof, the statement of the lemmas are important. Okay. So, again define. So, you can see the repeated use of the same set of ideas. Okay. So, x sub t of t is equal to x of t plus t. And again by lemma 1. So, this is just a fixed translation, t is some fixed capital T is some fixed number. So, this is just a translation. So, x t is a solution of 1. And look at now x t. So, look at x t at t naught, and this by definition is t 0 plus t, and by hypothesis, now look at the hypothesis. So, this is x of t 0. So, here we have two solutions of 1, x t and x, and they have the same initial data at t equal to t 0. Again by uniqueness, x t is of t is equal to x of t for all t, and this is same as saying at that x of t. So, that is and completes the proof. That is fine. Okay. So, the solution, okay, remark the solution in lemma 3 is called a periodic solution with a period. Okay. So, let me stress that a period, this. Okay. So, if t is a period, so is n t for n equal to 1, 2, etc. Okay. So, we will pick up the one which is least. So, the smallest t, positive satisfying the hypothesis in lemma 3 is called D period. Okay. Of that solution. Okay. So, these are some terminologies. So, we will see the importance of this periodic solution little later as we go along. Okay, so, another concept. Now, we will introduce another concept. So, this is the equilibrium points or solutions of one. Okay, so, this is our next concept. So, definition. So, you pick a point, I generally use this x bar is called an equilibrium point. Or solution of one. Okay, so whatever the concept we are doing, all refers to that one. Okay, that's remember that. If f of x bar is 0. Okay, so let me explain. So in case of when n is bigger than 1. So, this consists of, so this let me explain this what that. So, so let x bar be x 1 bar x n bar. So, this is in R n and let me expand this system of equations. So, that means I have f 1 of x 1 bar x n bar is 0 etcetera f n. Okay. So, that means the components of x bar, this x 1 bar x 2 bar x n bar are the solutions of the simultaneous equations f 1 bar x 1 bar etcetera 0. Okay. So, in case of f 1 is linear, so this is just a system of algebraic equations. If f 1 or any of the f's are non-linear, so more in many examples we consider them as polynomials, then we have a set of non-linear equations and we are seeking a common 0. There may be one, there may be many. Okay, so, we will see in examples. Okay, so, this you should remember this f x bar means this components x 1 bar x 2 bar x n bar, they satisfy this system of equations. Okay, that you should remember that. Okay. Okay. So, another interpretation. So, of this equilibrium points, thus equilibrium points. Are the constant solutions. Okay, so let me stress that. Constant solutions. So constant solutions means it does not change with time. So, if x does not change with time, then the derivative is 0, that means f of x is 0. So, just look at the condition here, x not equal to f x in either one equation or more equation. So, when x is a constant solution, that dx by dt is 0. So, that means f of x is 0, and conversely, if it is an equilibrium point, then f of x is 0 there, and then we get that constant solution. Okay. So, equilibrium points are nothing but the constant solutions of one. Okay. They are solutions, that is important. Okay. So, if so, now immediately you see that if x bar is an equilibrium point, and now I want to look at the orbit of that x bar, since that itself is a solution. So, we immediately obtain that x bar, its positive orbit, of course, now why only positive orbit, can also consider negative orbit, but we are interested in the future. So, that is why we only consider the positive orbit. So, here is a situation. So, where we can immediately determine the entire orbit, the positive orbit, they are all equal to the singleton set x bar. Okay. So, that is the beauty of this equilibrium points. Okay. Okay. So, in this case, we can immediately determine its orbits. Okay. So, now another important thing that is connected with equilibrium point is this following lemma. So, let me do this thing and then we go to examples. Okay. So, we also see the significance of these equilibrium points and what happens if the system does not have equilibrium points. Okay. Say if this, for example, this f may never be 0, then that particular system will not have any equilibrium points. So, we will see through some examples. So, what is that significance, and when there are equilibrium points, what is their significance? We will see all these things in detail. Okay. So before that, so if x bar is an equilibrium point, then we know its orbit precisely. So, if I have a non-trivial orbit, what does that mean? So, it is an orbit not passing through the equilibrium point, then that cannot intersect this orbit. Okay. So, that is because we have seen in lemma 2 that either two orbits are the same or they are disjoint all the time. Okay. So, if I have a solution not pass, it cannot pass through this thing because again uniqueness, because that is the only solution passing through the given equilibrium point. So, if I start with another solution, that orbit will never intersect this equilibrium point. Okay. But it can approach. Okay. This, so, that is what the lemma says. So, let x t be a solution of 1 such that limit x t as t tends to infinity exists. Okay. When we say exists, so we always mean a finite number and equals x bar. So this is in Rn. Okay. So let me again write it component wise. So that is, so if you take the jth component, of the solution, this is x bar. So this is for, okay. So that I am assuming this solution x t has this limit, okay. So then necessarily, then x bar is equal. So, if a solution has a finite limit as t goes to infinity, so this also you can do it for t tending to minus infinity. So, necessarily the limit is an equilibrium point. Okay. So, now just for curiosity you can just argue that suppose the system does not have any equilibrium point. Okay. So, that means no solution can have this finite limit. Okay. So, in most of the cases in the absence of equilibrium points, the all the solutions of the given system will be unbounded. Okay. We will see through some examples. So, that is one significance of the equilibrium points. Okay. So, let me just give a quick proof of this. Okay. So, let me write again component wise. Okay. So, fix h greater than 0. Okay. Then x of t plus h is also a solution. So, you are repeatedly using that lemma 1, okay, you see that. Okay. So, that is an important thing, is also a solution. Okay. And as t tends to infinity, t plus h also tends to infinity. Okay. So, therefore, I have limit x t plus h as t tends to infinity is also x bar. Okay. And since x bar is finite, the difference, if I take the difference, so therefore, so, this is not of the infinity minus infinity form. So, so we can separate the limit. So, this is calculus. So, since both are x bar and they are finite, so this is 0. So, this is not of the, so I can write this as limit of x t plus h minus limit x t, because both are finite. Okay. And now look at this component wise. So, let me write this. Component wise for each j equal to 1 to n and use the mean value theorem. Each x j is a differentiable function. So, by mean value theorem, so this is just x h x j dot at some point theta h. So, this is theta is 0 1. okay. But x is not an arbitrary function, it is a solution of 1, okay. X is a solution of 1. So, by using the equation, so this is f of, now let me write it as x of t plus f. Because x satisfies equation 1, system 1. Okay. That's and now you see, look at this limit. So I am using this limit star. Okay. So the left hand side, this one goes to 0 as t goes to infinity. That is from star. We are seeing it, and therefore, since h is positive, so I conclude that therefore, limit f of f j for each j x of t plus h as t goes to infinity is 0. Okay. And now, the continuity, so this is again part of the preliminaries in analysis. So, this each f j is continuous function, x is a continuous function. So, I can push this limit inside here, and so this limit, let me just write that f j of x bar. Okay, so that means, so this implies f j x bar is 0, and this is true for all j. So, that implies x bar okay. So, with these few preliminaries, now we consider some examples. So, first the simplest thing, just you consider this 1D. So, most of the examples are 1D examples. So, 1 except perhaps the last one, if I am able to come to that thing, that will be a 2D example. So, this is 1D, that means just a single equation. And so, f of x is x square here, and so the zeros of the that function is just here, in this case it is only 0. So, x power equal to 0 is the only equilibrium point. Okay. So, given, so you can also write the explicit solution. So, you should complete all these steps, then this x t is a solution, x of 0 is. So, for most calculation we just take t 0 equal to 0, but without this, using this solution, I would like to calculate the orbits, positive orbits for arbitrary x naught in R. Okay. So, for that just draw this line. And here is your equilibrium point. So, the orbit of that equilibrium point is obviously that singleton. Okay. So, any orbit starting here, so automatically it has to stay there, and any orbit starting in the left, it will stay here because it cannot intersect with that orbit. So, orbit, so this if x 0 is 0, then this orbit is just 0. So, any other orbit cannot intersect. So, if x 0 is positive, let us see what happens. So, let me use a different color here. So, x 0 here, and without the knowledge of the solution, let us try to see how the solution moves. Okay. Just so some simple calculus would help us in most of the 1D problems. So, look at the equation. It says dx by dt is equal to x square, and x square is always non-negative. So, derivative of that solution is non-negative, that means the solution is always increasing with time. Okay. So, if I start here, the solution has to only move to the right. Okay. Simple calculus, I am not using anything here. Okay. So, using that fact, so let me write here. So, you just see that x 0 is zero infinity, and the positive orbit is just x 0 infinity, and since it will stay here and it keep on increasing, we can just conclude that this x t, of course, it will not exist in this case, particular case, for all there is a t star. So, let when this denominator becomes 0, so it is infinity. The solution is unbounded here. So, the because it is the orbit is this entire 0 infinity, the solutions in this case are unbounded. So, now look at a point here and the negative. So, x naught is okay. Again the solution is increasing. So, there is no because x naught is x square, again it is increasing. So, it will move in this direction, and there is a barrier here. So, it cannot cross that thing. So, it at the most it can reach that in infinite time. So, in this case you verify that x 0 is minus infinity 0 and zero. And limit of x t, and in this case it exists for all time here, it is 0. Okay. So, verify these facts. Okay. So, this just follows from this simple analysis. So, I do not really require this explicit solution. Okay. Okay. So, before moving to the next example, so, let me just in remaining 10 minutes. So, let me just write this calculus lemma. So, it is very easy to prove. We will include in the, we will discuss in the discussion on preliminaries on analysis. Okay. So, let chi be a real valued function defined on an interval a b, and this could be entire R. okay, it could be finite, infinite, it doesn't matter, semi infinite, whatever, any arbitrary interval of the real line, and chi is a real valued function defined on that interval satisfy okay, either, so one of the two conditions. So, let me, chi is bounded above and chi is non decreasing. Or chi is bounded below and chi is non-increasing. Then limit excuse me. So, again let me recall that when we say that limit exists, it is a finite real number. Okay. It is very easy to prove. In the first case, this limit will be the supremum of chi t, and in the second case, it will be infimum of chi t. Okay. So, we will discuss more about this in when we discuss preliminaries. Okay. So, using this thing, so let me now consider second example. So, this is logistic model. Of population growth. So, again 1D. So, x dot equal to x into 1 minus x. So, usually there are some constants here. So, here I have just normalized and assume that the maximum plausible population is 1. Okay. Now, you can, one can normalize that, otherwise you can also put numbers, that is no problem. So, in fact, in the discussion on physical models, you see actual numbers, but it does not matter. Okay. So, if so, again here one can write down the explicit solution, but without that explicit solution, I would like to draw the orbits through arbitrary points. So, let me just, so since it is a population model, we are interested only in positive solutions and see whether we get positive solutions if we start initially at positive initial data. Okay. So, here the equilibrium, there are two equilibrium points. So, equilibrium points zero and one. So, look at the place where this right hand side is 0, that is x equal to 0 or x equal to 1. Okay. So, then by the discussion on lemma 1, lemma 2, etcetera, etcetera. So, if I start a solution here, its orbit cannot go beyond this, because that will intersect the orbit of this equilibrium point 0 and equilibrium point at 1. So, it cannot intersect. So, if I have an x 0 here, the solution always remains in this interval 0 1, and similarly if I start x 0 here, the orbit will always remain there. So, let me just do that thing. So, if zero x zero less than 1, and again look at the equation. Equation says x dot is equal to x into 1 minus x, and in this case we have already seen that the solution lies between 0 and 1 again. So, then the corresponding solution lies in 0, 1, and then you look at the equation, and from the equation we see that the solution is increasing, or at least not decreasing. X into 1 minus x, x always lies between 0 and 1. So, that product is positive. So, x dot is positive. So, x is increasing. Okay. And in the other case, so similarly, if x 0 is bigger than 1, then the corresponding solution lies in 1 infinity and is decreasing. Now, if you look at x into 1 minus x, x is bigger than 1. So, the second factor is negative. So, it is decreasing. Okay, simple calculus. We are not using anything else here, just simple calculus. Okay. So, if x 0 belongs to 0, 1, now you can write down the orbits. So, the orbit is just 0, 1, and the positive orbit, this is more important for us. X 0 1, because it is increasing. Okay, so that is because it is increasing. So, if x 0 is bigger than 1, then the orbit is 1 infinity, and the positive orbit, now it is decreasing. So, you see that 1 x 0. Okay. So, with this thing, we will continue in the next lecture. So, what happens to the limit of this thing? So, go and do all this, whatever gap is there. So, try to fill in all those gaps, and we will see in the next lecture. Thank you.